It took me 5 years to finish my PhD. I applied to, like the traditional advice says, I applied to 10 schools, three schools that I thought they were the ones hard to get, coming from Wayne State, which is top 200 institution. So I knew these were, my GPA, by the way, at that time was 4.0. So I thought that I could apply anywhere I wanted to, although I knew that the system, it's not always, you know, generous depending on where you apply to. I applied to top three schools, and I applied to three schools that I thought they were nice schools, but maybe not on the top level, but I did have possibilities to make it into it. And I applied to, I think, four fallback schools, just in case. I won't say any names. I did make it to Stony Brook, which was my first school on the second group. And I got an offer for an additional supplement to work in a particular area, given that my dual background helped it out. I applied to applied mathematics program, and having a degree in computer science and a degree in mathematics seemed to be a good match for them. So they, before I accepted, they offered me a supplement on my scholarship, so I would be inclined to take on to them. I did take the GRE. I took the GRE, the general GRE, and I took the math GRE. I did, my thesis was focused on three different projects, all of them in the area of computational geometry, artificial intelligence, and robotics. Again, since my background was mixed background between computer science and mathematics, my advisors thought that it was a good idea to do projects that will walk this wide line that it's in between mathematics and computer science, where a lot of the content is shared. So three of my projects were done on that. Stay focused. Keep the eye on the ball. It's a long process. There is a long interaction with your advisor. Although relationships can have many different, you know, flavors. You can have a good relationship. You can have a so-so relationship. In my case, it was good. But I find that it's really hard to keep the motivation going after 4 or 5 years. And there's a point where, as a graduate student, you want to graduate. And sometimes that's not, your timeline doesn't go on the same line that, with the timeline of your advisor or your faculty advising group. So it's important to keep the eye on the ball. While you do grad school, you see a lot of people who change their minds halfway, or that you meet people who've been doing it for 7, 8 years and that they don't have any clear idea of when they're going to finish. So it's easy to get demotivated. I think the hardest part and the important part is to figure out, okay, what's what I want to do next and how do I get to next? And that's what I think kept me going at that time.